Hi guys, this is Sajak from dwadwin.com, and in this video, we'll show you how to flash the latest Pixel OS ROM based on Android 14 on any Android phone. So please take a backup of all the data on your phone and then let's get started. First and foremost, you have to download and extract the Android SDK platform tools. So go to my guide and get it from here. Once you have done the download, extract them onto your PC. You could extract them anywhere you want. In my case, I've done the extraction in C drive, as you could see. And these are the files of platform tools. Once that is done, you will now have to enable USB debugging and OEM unlocking. USB debugging is required to execute ADB command, whereas OEM unlocking is required to unlock the bootloader on your phone. So let's now carry out both this task. For that, go to the settings menu on your phone, then go to about phone and tap on build number or MIUI version 7 times. You will then get a prompt that you are now a developer. So go back, then go to system or additional settings, and you should now see developer option. So go there and enable the toggle next to OEM unlocking as well as USB debugging. So do so and you will get a prompt on your phone. In case of Redmi, Xiaomi and Poco phones, you might get one more prompt. So just tap on OK and check mark I'm aware of all the risks and hit the OK button, and you might get one more RC key prompt. So again tap on OK, and with this the debugging is now enabled. So let's now verify the same. So go to platform tools folder address bar, type in cmd and hit enter. This will launch command prompt inside platform tools. Now type in adb devices and make sure that you are getting a serial ID. If you are not getting any ID, then unplug and replug your phone from the PC, disable and re-enable USB debugging, tap on revoke USB debugging, use the official cable that came with your phone, and use the USB 2.0 port on your PC. So carry out this USB tweaks and make sure that you are getting an ID. Once you are getting this ID, you are now good to go ahead. So next up, you will now have to unlock the bootloader on your phone. For that, I made a separate guide on the same. If you are using a Xiaomi phone, you will have to use a Mi Unlock tool. For all the other phones such as the Pixel and the OnePlus, they could use the Fastboot flashing unlock command. For Realme phone, they have to use the Realme in-depth test APK app and all such. I made a guide on all those situations in all those phones. You could go to my guide and get hold of all the tweaks. So anyways, moving on. Once you have unlocked the bootloader, your next course of action is to download the latest Pixel OS ROM. So you could get it from here. So download the ROM, and once you have got the ROM, generally the ROMs are in ARM64, A64, BGN, BVN, but as of now, when it comes to Pixel OS, there is no such variant, it's a single variant. So simply download it from here. If in the near future you find that there are quite a lot of variant, then you could verify the same regarding which variant should you download. So for that, you just have to download the app known as Travel Info, then go to the details tab, and from here have a look at this section. If it's showing as VNDK is not in light mode, then you will have to download the non-VNDK ROM. On the other hand, if it's showing as VNDK is in light mode, then you will have to download the VNDK ROM. But as of now, the ROM is not in any such variant. So simply get the ROM from here. Once you have got the ROM, you will now have to extract it. So let me show you. Currently, the ROM will be in a .exe format. So for extraction, you could use the 7-zip software. Once you have installed the 7-zip software, right click on it and select show more option. Then go to 7-zip and select extract to, and it will extract the ROM. Once you have done the extraction, you will get the IMG file. So let me show you. This is the IMG file. You will now have to transfer this IMG file inside the platform tools folder on your PC. So with this, we have got the GSI ROM inside the platform tools folder. Once that is done, let's now move ahead. So now you will have to get hold of the vbmeta file. This should be the same file which is currently installed onto your phone. You could verify the same from the stock firmware which is currently installed, and that could be verified via the build number on your phone. So either check out the build number or go to about phone, and for instance in my case it's the 14060. So I'll have to download the same firmware version. Apart from that, you could also verify the same from the build number if it's showing, or either the build number or the MIUI version, both will do. In case of Xiaomi, it's the MIUI version. For all the other phone, it should be the build number. So make sure to download the same firmware which is currently installed onto your phone. Once you have got the firmware, you'll have to extract it. Upon extracting, you will get a couple of files, or rather quite a lot of files. And out of all those files, you only need the bbmeta.img file. So in my case, this is the firmware. Let me check just a minute. So as you could see, in my case, this is the ROM 14.0.6.0 version. Also make sure that it corresponds to the same region which is currently on your phone. So in my case, it's the India region, so I'm using the same region as well. So go to your firmware. In Xiaomi, the firmware is usually in the .tgz format. You will have to extract it using 7-zip. Then you will get a .tar file. Upon extracting .tar, you will then get this folder, and you could then go to the images folder and get hold of the vbmeta file. In case of OnePlus, it's a payload.bin file, so you will have to extract that file using the fastboot enhance tool. Just copy paste the payload bin file inside the fastboot enhance folder and go to the payload dumper tab, click on browse and choose the payload bin file, click on open, and then go to the partition tab and select the vbmeta file from here, and then hit the extract button. I have made a separate guide and a video on the same. You could refer to my guide to get the job done. Anyways, in my case, it's the Xiaomi phone, so I'll be using the my ROM. So this is the ROM which I am using. So if you're using a Xiaomi phone, then go to the images folder and you should then get the vbmeta file. So you will now have to transfer this file to the platform tools folder on your PC. So as of now, both the vbmeta.img file, which should correspond to the currently installed firmware on your phone, and the GSI ROM should both be inside the platform tools folder. So moving on, once we have transferred both this file, let's now move ahead with the flashing steps. So for that, you will first and foremost have to boot your phone to fastboot mode. So open the CMD window and type in ADB reboot bootloader and hit enter, and your phone will now boot into fastboot mode in a matter of few seconds. So let's just wait for the time frame and then we will move ahead with the next step. So the fastboot screen might vary depending on the phone that you are using. Currently I'm using a Poco F4 phone, so this is a fastboot screen in my case. Once your phone is in the fastboot mode, you will have to type in fastboot devices and hit enter, and make sure that you are getting a serial ID. If you are not getting any ID, then you will have to install fastboot drivers. I have made a separate guide on the same. You could refer to my guide and install the fastboot drivers. Once you have installed these drivers, your next course of action is to right click on the Windows icon and select device manager. Then expand the Android phone section and make sure that your phone is being shown as Android bootloader interface. So this, as well as the serial ID next to fastboot, signifies that your PC is able to read the phone in fastboot mode, and we are now good to go ahead. So now our first course of action is to disable the verification check by flashing the vbmeta file. So for that, you just have to copy this entire command and verify that the vbmeta file is there inside the platform tools folder. If that's well and good, then simply copy this entire command and then paste it in the CMD window. So just a minute, let me do that as well. So paste it here and hit enter, and with this the verification has been disabled and we could now proceed ahead to flash the GSI ROM. So next up, you will now have to boot your phone to fastboot D mode, because flashing the GSI ROM is done in the fastboot D mode only. So again, copy this command and hit enter, and your phone will now boot into the fastboot D mode, and it could take a couple of seconds. Again, the fastboot D screen might also vary depending on the phone that you are using. Anyways, we are now in the fastboot D mode. So now you will have to remove a partition from your phone so as to make space for the GSI ROM. By default, the system partition will not have enough size to incorporate the GSI ROM, so we will have to make some space for that. So for making space, you will have to remove the product A partition from your phone. For removing that partition, simply copy this entire command and paste it in the CMD window and hit enter, and the product A partition has now been removed from our phone and we are now good to go ahead. So next up, you could now flash the GSI ROM onto your phone. So for the ease of convenience, let's rename the file to something shorter. So let's just rename it to GSI and hit enter, and the complete name becomes gsi.img. So now we could flash the GSI ROM to the system partition on our phone. So type in fastboot flash system gsi.img and hit enter, and the flashing should now begin in a few seconds. So let's just wait for the time frame and then we'll verify the result. So as you could see, the flashing has now started and it's currently going 1 out of 16. It will flash 16 files and the entire process usually takes around 5 to 6 minutes. So let's just wait for the time frame and then we'll be back. So guys, the flashing is now complete as you could see from here. So your next course of action is to do a factory reset or a format data. For that, just type in fastboot-w. Do keep in mind that this will wipe off all the data from your phone. So make sure you have taken a backup beforehand. And now hit enter and it will now remove all the data from your phone. Once that is done, you could now safely reboot your phone to the OS. So let me verify the same one. So with this, we have removed the data and now we could reboot our phone to the OS. So just type in fastboot reboot and hit enter and your phone should now reboot to the newly flashed OS. Do keep in mind that the first boot up will take up some additional time frame. This is completely normal and nothing to worry about. In some cases, it might also take up to a minute, which is again completely normal. Let's just verify if the boot animation shows up or not. Once the boot logo shows up, so as you could see, the boot animation has started. So this signifies that the ROM has been flashed successfully and now we could proceed ahead and access the ROM. So it could take up to around 15 to 20 seconds, I guess. So let's just wait and then we will proceed ahead. As of now, I'll skip the initial setup process and take you to the OS. So let's just wait and check out the Pixel OS ROM. It's obvious that the Pixel OS ROM comes inbuilt with the G apps packages. While you will not get all the Google apps installed, but all the required and necessary and important Google apps will be there. You could then install the additional Google apps from Play Store or third-party sites. With that said, we are now in the setup screen as you could see. So it's also giving us the option to use an iPhone or iPad for restore. This is the first time I'm seeing this. So that's a great option. Anyways, let's skip all this for now. And let me set up my phone offline. Let's skip this as well. And it will now take only a few more seconds. So let's skip this. And with this, we are now in the Pixel OS, the latest based on Android 14, as you could see from here. These are the QoS tiles and this is the settings menu. First off is the PHS treble settings and these are the few tweaks that you will find in every PHS GSI ROM. First off is the Qualcomm features regarding this. If you are facing any audio issues, then you will have to enable the use alternate audio policy. Then apart from that, based on the OEM, you will get some additional features as well. In case of Xiaomi, you will get double tap to wake and sunlight mode. Then we have a few dose features and miscellaneous features. Under miscellaneous features, these are mostly for development purpose and only try to enable them if you know what you are doing, because something might go wrong if you enable or disable it. So it's something along the lines of hidden flags, as you could say. Experiment features you could select from here: Bluetooth workarounds, likewise expose aux cameras, force enable camera to API, especially for gcams. So to the gcam which are not working on GSI ROM, you could try to enable this and check out the results. So it's mostly for development purpose, and if something is not working along the expected line, then you could also try these things. And then we have some IMS features. So in case the network is not working, then you will have to create an IMS APN network and then get the job done. So apart from that, there are a few customization tweaks as well. So I can shape. Okay, so I take my words back. There aren't any customization under the PHA treble settings, but that shouldn't be a cause of concern. And as you could see, it's the default stock UI with just the required Google features and nothing more as such. Similar to how is the Pixel Experience ROM. And let me show you, this is the system reset option. And then we have the about phone section and it's the latest Android 14 build. So guys, on that note, I round up this video. If you have any queries, do let me know in the comment section, and thanks a lot for watching.